All right, welcome to Dean Bodie Show. Dean Bodie Show. Hey everybody, how's it going? What's going on? Happy Thursday, frozen tundra, Dallas, Texas day. Who's the good girl? Good girl, Bodie. Good girl, Bodie. She's the best girl in the world. Oh, yeah. DeanBodie.com. 800-878-9698. Bodie hotline, fun line. Call the Bodie line. Say something nice to Bodie. She wants to tell you about running around in the snow and the ice and everything nice. So DeanBodie.com is the website. We got the links on there. I want to get you over to the podcast. Social link will get you over to the YouTube channel, DeanBodie Space Show, YouTube channel, Apple, Spotify, wherever you get your podcasts. Hey, click the like button. If you like what's going on over here, Dean Bodie Show, it's a nice break in your day, cleaning out the cobwebs. We're helping you do that. Consider subscribing. And don't forget to click that notification bell so you don't miss any of these shows. Why? Because these are real shows. We're coming at you with real life stories, Dean Bodie style. And nobody does it like Dean Bodie. Numbers are going up every day. We thank you so much over here from Dean Bodie, touching with other parts of different countries and different parts of the lands across the world. That's a beautiful thing. And I think Portugal now is at the top of the list. Who knew? Thank you, Portugal. And that being said, regarding the podcast itself, if you can get over there, give it a nice 5-star rating and a nice shiny review, it'll give the algorithm a little shot in the, in the you-know-where and send it to the you-know-who and help things out a little bit in that direction. So, I hope you're having a great day today. And we're going through it over here in Texas, and we had no power, no water. No fun, oh my. No power, no water, no fun, oh my. And that was a little wild. So what was going on is, now I know how it feels to get shock treatments in the mental ward because, you know, the power goes off, okay? And you're like, okay, this is not good, number one. And then they're giving us a dose of power on for a couple of hours. We're talking sub-zero temperatures with the wind chill. Okay, 11 below. I mean, where am I? Alaska? So, you know, I thought I was living in Antarctica there for a second. They would be laughing at me right now. And they were doing this on and off thing. I've never experienced that in my life. Of course, you're glad when it comes on. You don't know when it's going to happen. And when the lights go out, the power goes out, and it's nighttime, not fun with sub-zero temperatures. So the inside of the apartment is freezing. And man, oh man, was that a wild ride. Bodie handles it way better than I am. The beautiful white wolf that comes from the wintry mountains of Japan is tapping into that 2,000 years of Japanese Shiba Inu DNA. And since we've been running around in the snow all week, I'm way more than impressed with Bodie. I am drawing strength from Bodie. Bodie is amazing. I'm so worried about her feet and the cold and the snow and the this. And she's running around looking at me like, you know, you ready? I'm pretty impressed by the whole thing, watching this beautiful white wolf named Bodie. Those of you that don't know, and I hold the picture up of Bodie, you'll see Bodie on the thumbnails too when you go to the social YouTube channel and see that's the Bodie, that's the energy behind the show. So watching her prance around in the snow and all that stuff, the funny thing is, before I get into the Bodie story and where she's got to go, number two, let's just say, is never close by, even in the snowy tundra. So with the on and off shock treatments of the power for 2 days in a row, on a couple hours, and then whammo, it just blasts off. I'm like, what's the Wizard of Oz? Who's controlling this whole thing? Like the man behind the curtain with all the switches and the levers, you know? Pretty crazy. You lose, sir. You know, you stole fizzy lifting drinks. You bumped into the ceiling, which now has to be washed and sterilized. You lose. Good day, sir. That's what I felt like. And then it would come back on again. And just as the heater would start to warm up the apartment, off again. I'm like, okay, just let's make a phone call. I'm ready to get picked up by the white paddy wagon. Put me in a straitjacket and take me over to the padded room palace. Okay, so anyway, we're making it through now. Today, the power has stayed on since last night. It looks like we're okay in the power department now. This is the longest it's ever been on. Thank you, God. Everything's more toasty, but the water went off. All right, nice going, water people. Pipes that are exploding and can't handle sub-zero. So the water went off, and, you know, I thought it was okay because in the beginning, it was the power. The water was coming, no problem. Now, they shut the whole water thing off so other pipes don't burst. Now, they got to go find the ones that have the cracks and the bursts and the leaks, and, of course, everything is underground. Then you got to fix it, and then, you know, cover it back up, and then flip the water valve back on. So today, I'm hoping that it comes back on because the rations of water is getting pretty slim. Nothing's open. Nobody's delivering. This is getting a little weird. So we're just sipping things. And you know, let me tell you something about intermittent fasting or fasting in general. It's coming in handy now, the practice I've had, because a couple bites here, we can go a while and you're not worrying about things as far as that goes. Your body can handle it. I've dropped down to 155 pounds as of today, almost hitting my all-time record. It was 154 back in the day. So this is wild. You know, having a gout flare up too when I'm this, when my weight is this light is a little bizarre also. And I'm getting to show you, since that adrenal gland insufficiency I went through, my whole body got body slammed. So I know my kidneys aren't functioning as well as they were, expelling the uric acid, the extra uric acid. It's going to take time to rebuild, gang. So we're going to keep on it. We're staying low glycemic, low purine, you know, intermittent fasting as a tool. Obviously, no sugar. And, you know, no bad starchy carbs that turns into sugar. And, you know, get the water up, doing the healthy lemonade that I make with the apple cider vinegar. And little things like that as the body continues to heal and function better. And I'll get to where I, you know, give myself that cheat meal like once a week. And live like that. That's all. And a couple days in a row of the red meat gave me a flare up. And I'm like, you know, let me tell you, it can get a little frustrating, but you got to stay on it. You got to reevaluate. You got to tweak things. And that's just the way it goes. So that's what we're doing. And when the body heals and gets back up again, then, you know, you don't have to worry about any meds helping you out. You don't have to worry about any crisis care with any kind of meds, any long term. Once the body gets dialed in, then you can always wean off. Just like type 2 diabetes can be reversed and people can get off insulin, get off their diabetes meds, but they got to stay strict. It's a lifestyle for the rest of your life with the low glycemic meal plan, and you stay on that, in that lane. You know, you can go on meds if you want and eat whatever you want and just do this and do that. And some people do that. Hey, it is your life. It's your choice. Be happy with what's going on now. Being happy is important. So live your life, man. You know, you want to dive into a bag of this or pop open a frozen thingy of that, do it. You know, something to say about keeping yourself happy between your ears as a mental health remedy. Hey, listen, nothing wrong with that. So find your thing. I'm doing my thing over here, giving you what's going on over here. And not to go down that rabbit hole too far today, because we got frozen tundra, no power, no water, no fun, oh my, going on. Okay? So we're waiting for the water to come back right now. And amazingly enough, I had the water that I did. in my pure water filter on the counter container that was halfway full still. I had some fat water from the Bulletproof guy, half a dozen of those in the fridge, some smaller water bottles that happened to be full. Bodhi's got to drink water. We're going doing what we got to do over here until this thing gets turned on. And the temperatures right now are still below freezing, so the snow's staying on. The snowfall, the last one happened yesterday over late night and into the morning, and now we're done. Now, once we get through today, the warmer temperatures will start coming, and as Texas does, it goes from low to high in a pretty rapid pace, and, you know, everything will melt, pipes will get fixed, the world will get back to normal. Everybody's going to start freaking out now about the global warming and all of this stuff and the climate change. The climate's been changing every single year everywhere. Sometimes somebody gets slammed by a tsunami. Sometimes somebody gets plowed by the hurricane, Category 5. Sometimes somebody gets wailed on by the tornado. Sometimes somebody gets crazy, whacked out by a monster earthquake, and then they get body slammed again by the aftershock. Sometimes somebody gets the snow when they weren't expecting it. Sometimes somebody gets some kind of crazy, I don't know, freezing rain comes plowing through. Oh, well, sometimes it's just too windy, and we're worried about, wow, it's so windy, it's messing up my hairdo. Or sometimes, you know, we just get all wrapped up in, you know, I don't know, the landscaping, or there's too many doggy poops out there in the grass that you got to navigate through where I live. Is all of that part of climate change? Okay, so one day at a time, let's be grateful for what we have. We're stronger than we think. Draw strength from Bodhi. Bodhi the wolf is running around in the snow. Now we're going for the poopy runs now, the last few days in a row. We're pros at it now, okay? So now she takes me over the river and through the woods to go to her places that she likes to take a poopy. And that's just the way it goes with Bodhi, you know? She doesn't go inside. She can't go in the toilet. So we do it. And we just, you know what? There's something about not letting anything break your routine. And just do it anyway. It gives me my cardio walk. Yes, it's cold and super cold and whatever, but Bodhi gives me the strength, and we go on our walk and we come back. And it really, it's not that big of a deal. You know, and when you test yourself like that and go through it, you start to develop a little strength and realize what you can do. You know, I can bitch about it all day long and whine and cry about it, or just put an extra few layers of shirts on, put a layer of jacket, put a jacket over that jacket, put a sock hat on my head, put another layer of fuzzy gloves on my hands, and we're off and running. I just happen to have these one pair of boots that I got, luckily, and I never wear them because they're dress boots. I don't want to ruin them. But sometimes you're like, okay, well, they're not dress boots anymore. So now they're snow hiking boots. And they come up way up past the ankle. They're real solid. They got little rubber treads, one on the heel and one on the front. They're working out perfect. The toe is real hard, and it's got, you know, where it's covered, as opposed to the sneakers that have all that mesh on top and the snow gets on top and, you know, your foot gets wet. You don't want that. So these are coming in handy. And I'm starting to think about the stuff that I have. Thank God I had enough paper towels and toilet paper. And Huggy wipes, and I wipe Bodhi's feet and her tushy with, and all that, and my own. So, speaking of turlets, hey, Millie!
Yeah! You hear what he's talking about with the frozen weather in Dallas? He's really going through it there with Bodhi. But Bodhi's been being real strong and walking through the snow no problem. Way to go, Bodhi, huh? I know! It's unbelievable! We love Bodhi! Bodhi's so strong! Way to go, Dean Bodhi!
So, that being said, speaking of toilets, can't flush the toilet. So I had to go and do, hey, welcome to Dean Bodie's homemade toilets. Can I help you? So I took a large kitchen bag, right? And thank God I have a bunch of those extra. And I lined the toilet with the tall, large kitchen bag, you know, put it in the toilet, line it, that one bowl, lift up the seat, and then line it, put the seat down, put a layer of paper towel down to act as the catcher for the poopster, and whatever. And it's working out good. So then when you're done, you take the garbage bag out, throw it in your regular garbage pan, garbage in your regular garbage. You can tie that up. And then when I take Bodie out, out goes the poopy garbage. And this is it, man. It's working out perfectly fine. And, you know, and if you have to do one layer, put another paper towel layer on top of that, and you can do another layer of your business, you know, and then you take it out. Let me tell you, man, you get real creative when you're going through something like this. And I have a feeling that today might be a rough day with no water again, but hopefully they'll get the right repair done and we can get that kick back on. I got the faucets cranked open. So when it does get turned on, we're going to know it. And we'll move forward from this and go into, you know, the next season and keep moving forward. And that's the way it goes. So, listen, let's see what's going on over here, Dean Bodie. We got a lot to talk about today. But that's what's happening with the weather. I hope you guys are safe out there and taking care of each other. Remember, take care of yourself so you can take care of somebody else. Let's see what's going on over here, Dean Bodie. Zippity-doo-da, zippity-yay. It's freezing out here. What a crazy day. Zabba-da-boo-boo, yabba-da-da. It's cold out. Yadda-dee-da. So, Sundays are deceiving. Oh, yeah. Bodie enjoyed a bully stick popsicle. And not only do we have a frozen pool out here. That was wild to see. You could probably go skating on it. And, yeah. And Bodie's dealing with her folliculitis, as I'm dealing with my ridiculous-itis. All right? So, Bodie finds a popsicle outside. But before I get into this, I was thinking how Sundays can be deceiving, right? Sundays, it is a kind of a day off for most people. That's usually the barbecue day, the family day. But you end up kind of forgetting you got to work the next day. And that's the day everybody's got the hangover on the Monday morning. That's the day everybody feels miserable from eating and stuffing their faces too much. So it's got this Sunday's got this deceiving day off, but tomorrow's a work day kind of vibe for most people. Little tricky Ricky that Sunday, isn't it? So I remember I had the Geek Squad, okay, from Best Buy, come out and was bringing me a new TV, okay? He's going to install it doing this. This guy was a big dude, and it was on a Monday. He was sweating, dripping like a pig all over my apartment. It was unbelievable. I mean, really sweating, and he's telling me, sorry about the sweating. He had to say something because it was so, I was like, wow. You know, watching this guy dripping like over my magazines on my coffee table. I'm like, really? So he's doing this. He's sweating like a monster. Okay. You think he was in the Sahara Desert. He says, sorry about the sweating. I give him some paper towels to pat himself dry. He goes, yeah, I had a big barbecue yesterday. Didn't really drink, you know. And I'm like, looks like you're sweating out the alcohol. Yeah, I know. I just had a couple of beers. But we really ate a lot of barbecue. That's probably... Everybody always says, just a couple of beers. You know what that means? You drank a case. As big as you were, as big as you are, dude. This guy put down a 12-pack easy. And then you can see it just coming. I've been there enough times, right? Being a recovering alcoholic, drug addict myself, I know more hangovers than most. I know what sweating that stuff out is big time. So that being said, I went through that and it was kind of crazy. He ended up finishing the installation and went And that was one of those things. Have you ever gone to the doctor and had him remove a ball of earwax out of your ear? Isn't that fun? The other day, I'm cleaning out my ears with the Q-tip. I remember when I was in college, I had an instructor said, don't ever put anything smaller than your elbow in your ear. I'm like, oh, okay. Because the wax has a purpose and the hair and the you can, you know, penetrate and mess up your eardrum and pierce it if you're not careful. Listen, be careful. But you got to get some stuff out once in a while with a Q-tip. Okay, so everybody's got their theories. But I remember having that class. He said, don't put anything smaller than your elbow in your ear. I'm like, okay, first of all, nobody can get their elbow in their ear. All right, smart guy. And second, and I got something in there, you got to get it out. All right, so I remember going to the ear doctor one time, the regular doctor. I had something in there. And he goes and does the whole hot water rinse and does the whole zippity-doo-dah on my ear and ends up going in there with the tool and pulls out this big ball of wax. I'm like, holy moly, where did that come from? So he got that out, and I was like, I thought that I was going to end up feeling like a whole different person. I didn't really, but I was just glad that it was out. Okay? I worked with this medical doctor one time relating to this ear thing. He gave me a technique that he did with a paper clip. I never had really the nerve to do it, but he would open up the paper clip and make like a little L shape on one side, bend it, right? And make the rest of it straight. Push that in your ear. Keep your fingers really loose so it slides and you don't push too hard. And he goes, then just kind of go around the ear, and that little curved part is going to scoop and collect the wax, and then you pull it out. I said, really? The medical doctor with the ear cleaning technique with the paper clip. I'm like, that was pretty clever. I have never done it because I'm just afraid of I'm going to do a slip and I'm going to poke a hole in my eardrum. And, you know, but that was one of his techniques. Okay, listen, I don't recommend you do this at home. I'm just telling you one of the stories, okay? So don't give me this whole, hey, Dean Bodie said you can take a paper clip. That came from a medical doctor. He showed me. I have never done it. So take caution, all right? Just a little thing I'm sharing with you, okay? So Bodie's outside today. We're going for our walk in the snow. And we get down, she does her business. We go down three buildings and down the parking lot, over to the next apartment complex, all the way down the end of the sidewalk, around the corner to their back building. And Bodie's running around trying to find a place to go do her business, and she still doesn't have to go. So we go over, we go down that sidewalk, over the next parking lot, through the other apartments, around the corner, and she finds a spot and does it. And then we had to backtrack and all that, because some of the areas are just like all ice, and if you try one of those moves, you're going to break your tuchus. So she finally did it. Hey, and this is the one time, okay? The one time, because of the tundra and the deep snow and whatever, I left Bodie's poop right where it was, and they're just going to have to deal with it the one time without, you know, getting the poopy bag out and all that stuff. This is the one exception to the rule. Not every single day when it's normal. Okay? So, listen. Kind of a little confession, but that's what happened. So, we're coming back, and Bodie finds one of her bully sticks we left in the apartment building's way over. She picks it up. It's like a frozen little popsicle now. Let's call it the bully stick popsicle. And the bully sticksicle. The bully stick wixicle. Okay, so she picks it up and she picks it up all proud and walks it all the way back in her mouth, sticking out like a cigar, all the way back home. Almost all the way back. One building over, she's got a spot, and she decided just to stand there with all 4 feet in the snow and eat the whole thing and digest the entire bully stick popsicle. Nice going, Bodie. Way to go, popsicle treat. Whenever you gonna get one of those again? I was a little bit jealous. I didn't have a popsicle. So, it's making me crave one though right now. God, it makes me think about those bomb pops from the ice cream man. Those red, white, and blue bomb pops and the screwballs with the triangle little cup with the bubble gum on the bottom. And you get that little wooden spoon and dig through the icy until you get to that bubble gum on the bottom. Oh, man, that was the screwball. You had the bomb pop. Yes, you had the chocolate eclair on a stick. And you had the strawberry shortcake on a stick. And all the other goodies that the ice cream man had. Unbelievable. And they also had the bomb pop too, I remember. It was like a yellow and a brown one. I think it was like a banana and like a chocolate. Crazy good. And those popsicles that you can keep in the freezer that are one big stick. And you just keep squeezing and biting pieces off in your mouth. And they come in different flavors. Orange, cherry, and grape, and lemon. I could eat these things all day long, but I can't do the sugar like that anymore. Otherwise, uric acid says, hello, and we're going to limp around for a couple days. Oh my gosh. So it all comes back to that, right? Anyways, man, we're having a great day over here, Dean Bodie. We're making the best of what we got. And Bodie, the white wolf walking through the snow, is impressing me by the day. Now I know what it's like to watch a little white wolf deal with this kind of climate. And I'm just blown away by the whole thing. She's given me strength, and I'm passing the strength on to you so you can keep going. Bodie is our strength. Bodie's telling you, don't worry about the snow and the tundra. It's going to be okay. Bodie's telling you, like, look, ration the water, do your little sippity sip, and let everybody fix stuff. It's going to be fine. And that's how we roll. That's how you got to roll. So let's just take a look over here. There's a couple more things I wanted to go over. Other than we did have a frozen swimming pool. That was wild. Probably not that solid where you can skate on it. I wouldn't take the chance. But it looks like you can. Maybe you can. I don't know. Let me see here. I wanted to... Yeah, we talked about how Bodie's strong. She's the greatest. And we're doing our thing, man. Oh, yeah, well, the fragile life, as we call it now. We can talk about that. And how long do you go before washing your sheets? There's the question of the day. Hot soup, swollen tongue. Hot soup, swollen tongue. So how long does it take? How long do you go before you wash the sheets on your bed? How long can you go? Well, I say, well, it all depends on how much Febreze you use. If you got a lot of Febreze around, you can extend the life of the sheets. Because of all the bombs that you let off during the night, get handled by the Febreze. So, how often to wash the sheets depends on how much Febreze you have. That's the equation. That's how I do it. Okay, so once the Febreze is gone, or you've really just gone too much of a thing, or you have a messy mess. You got kids and whatever, you know, that whole thing. That's a whole nother project. But I was thinking about the people around in apartments that have 3-4 kids. And they all poop all day. Where are you going to put it? Hopefully they designed one of my, you know, Dean Bodie makeshift toilets. I don't know. I might package it and market it. Who knows? How to make a toilet when you need one. So that's pretty wild. So that's the whole thing about the sheets formula. That's the whole thing too. I wanted to also mention, we did the earwax talk, you know, and to read the labels, man. You know, you make sure that you're reading labels carefully on the fine print on whether it's a collagen protein bar or whether it's anything to see what's going on with the added sugar and the, the high fructose corn syrups and all the other things you got to stay away from. If you can't pronounce the word, chances are you shouldn't put it in your mouth. And that's kind of how it goes. And I noticed you got to keep an eye on these things because I'm trying to get myself dialed in with that low glycemic. And you got to watch no grains, none of bad starchy carbs, none of that stuff. I'm even staying away from the fruit that I love, and I used to go through it by the tub on a daily. So the fructose, I'm pulling way back on all this. Got to give these kidneys an opportunity to heal and fix themselves. Got to create an environment for my body to fix and repair itself. And that's kind of where I'm at. So the more challenging I make it, the harder my life is going to be. And we're going to go. We're doing our crisis care with the meds if we have to. The long term, we're going to go on that. Get these numbers down while I'm sticking to the nutrition on top of it and everything else. So you can live your life and not make yourself crazy. And then we'll always reverse it and wean ourselves down. That's it. That's the plan. We can do it. If we can't do it, nobody can. Oh, yeah. So that's what's up. She's the good girl, Bodhi. She's the best girl in the world. Oh, yeah. The good girl, Bodhi. Yeah, the best girl in the world. Oh, yeah. DeanBodhi.com. 800-878-9698. Call the Bodhi line, fun line. Tell us what's going on in your neck of the woods with the weather. What's happening over there? We want to know. We want to hear your little zippity-doo-dah. Do a little sing-along. We'll sing it with you. That's how we do it over here, Dean Bodhi. We go back and forth and help each other. DeanBodhi.com is the website. Wherever you get the links on there, excuse me, where the links are on there, wherever you get your podcasts, Apple, Spotify, you know, we're on all the platforms. And the social link will get you on the YouTube channel, DeanBodhi Space Show YouTube channel. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. Let me see. Let's power up. Oh, ride from Dean Bodhi. Oh, yeah. Hey, Alexa, what's the joke of the day?
Today I have a joke about hair. What do you call a peroxide thief? Illegally blonde.
What do you call a peroxide thief? Illegally blonde. And let me tell you, sometimes when you drink too much smart water with the MCT oil. Oh, yeah. Little fireworks show. Because we're celebrating another day of life, okay? Have an awesome day. Man, oh man, we're going through it over here with the no water. The power is back on. Nice going, power, guys. Now we got to fix the frozen pipes. And we'll be back on track. So, hey, listen, make it a great day. And, you know, again, don't get caught up in all the COVID, schmovid, pandemic, schmandemic. Keep your immune system strong. Take care of yourself so you can take care of somebody else. Dean Bodhi Show's coming at you. DeanBodhi.com. Oh, yeah.